Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video, we are going to do the LED blink with different duration on time and off time using millis. We're not going to use the delay. You can get the code for this by clicking on the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. I have another video explaining millis and how it works with three examples, but in this video we're going to do the blink with on time and off time separate and independent. So you can select on time 5 seconds, off time half a second, or whatever you want in between. And we are going to use the millis during the processing time that this goes on and off. The system will not be waiting for other tasks, so all other tasks can be continued. And if you use the delay and until the time for the delay is expired, all other tasks will be waiting. So the millis is very useful tool to be utilized in this case. Let me explain now the wiring. This is a 330 ohm to 1 kilo ohm resistor that you can put. I put 1 kilo ohm. The larger the resistor, the lower the intensity of LED. If you want to know exactly to calculate the resistor for an LED, I have another video. The link will be below the video, so you can calculate exact resistance for an LED. This pin is connected to pin 3. And from here we have a resistor, and then the larger pin is on this side where the wire is, and the shorter pin is on the other side. You can see here that the resistor is connected to this pin, and the shorter pin is on the other side, which will be connected to the ground. And here is the ground pin on Arduino. Let me now explain the code. We are defining a pin for LED. In this case, I've used pin 3. You can use any other pin that you want. And then we are defining on duration and off duration. This is the time which the LED will be on or the LED will be off in terms of millisecond. For example, this is set to be 1000 millisecond or 1 second, and this is 200 millisecond or 0.2 seconds, 1/5 of a second. And then this is the integer and variable type integer with high. So this is the initial state of a LED. You can change it if you want, so you can change it to low. And then we have this long type variable called remember time. This is the time that is used internally. Do not change this. Inside the setup, we initialize up using pin mode LED. This is a DFI type 3 as an output, and then immediately we set the LED pin as LED state, either high or low, whatever you set, the LED will be in that state. And inside the loop, we check the LED state, which is true. At the beginning, it is high. We are comparing it using two equal sign. We say if it is high, do all these tasks. You see, if it starts from here to here, else from here to here. And then we check if millis is the time when the Arduino starts, the millisecond count will start here. And this is remembering it, and we check and subtract remember time. Remember time is initially zero, so which means the difference between this and this will be the millis. So if this is 500 minus zero, this will be 500. If it is greater than on time is the time that we set here, the on duration or off duration. So we check it at on duration, because this small, it will not do anything. Nothing happens, and else will not happen because it is high. The loop will continue, so which means it wastes time for this to pass. In the meantime, you can do any other task that you have in here. Between, because the time passes, this time become bigger until it is equal or greater than on time, which is over 1000 milliseconds. Then we change LED state to low. It's just a variable is set to low. And also we remember the current time. This current time, which at the beginning was zero, now the time when the LED is changed to low, we are remembering it. And because it was high now, this state, this will escape, and the code will come to this line. Here, digital write LED pin, pin 3, and we send the state which is low now. Now the LED will be low. Now, because this is loop, loop comes here and checks if it is high, which is false. So from here to here it will escape, it comes here. Again it checks it like before, millis, remember time, let's say this was 1000 and now it's 1100, it's not greater than off time, because off time is 500 or 1000, and it goes next time, third time, until it is greater than that, then we change the state to high, and then remember the time that we changed it. So this way we are remembering the time, and when the loop reaches here, it sets the new state. Remember, the loop continuously every time comes and sets the LED pin, and it will not have any effect. If it was high, it comes next time and set it high again, so it will not have any effect, but it happens. So this is the simplest state machine that you can do millis without using the delay, and all other processes that you have here will be executed without a delay. Also, you can move this in here. And comment this out, it will work. But remember, we have repeated the same code twice here, and that was better. But it's up to you, whichever way you want to proceed. And here is a demonstration. The time is set on for 1 second, as you can see, it turns on for longer period and off very short. Let's change it and make this 3 second and make this 5 second. Boot is uploaded now, so it's 3 seconds on and off is longer, 5 seconds. Or let's change it to 100 milliseconds and 500 milliseconds off. The code is uploaded, it will be very quick. I would like to sincerely thank the following people who have supported me via Patreon. Thank you for watching. This was how to use millis with Arduino to blink an LED with different duration of on and off. If you learned something, please thumb up, as this will help my video in a search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I'll try to answer and reply. You may subscribe to get updates of my upcoming videos.